Hello again out there in remote learning land. Today, we're jumping a little further into our weather topic with pressure and how air pressure can help predict the weather. It's pretty amazing how reliable it is. And you'll see, right? If like today, for example, well, yesterday anyway, we had those crazy storms. Well, not yesterday. That was Thursday, Friday, I'm thinking. Anyways. We had those crazy storms, and low pressure, of course, brings bad weather. And we'll talk further about that connection in a bit. We'll be working hard on those Do Now questions, as always. I want to start out with a classic song, just to have a little fun with the word pressure here. Enjoy for a minute. See how many of you guys know this one. There and pressure does indeed push down on us. It literally is the weight of the Earth's atmosphere pushing down on us that exerts air pressure. Okay, so make sure you read through your definition here. Okay, air pressure, that's your official definition, the weight or force of air pressure pushing down on a unit of surface area. Two little clips I wanted to show about how pressure manipulates things. The first one is from a movie called The Abyss, and literally it crushes a submarine. Pretty impressive stuff. And the second, of course, pressure being exerted on a styrofoam cup. There's this fierce submarine battle ensuing, and they're going to fall down a abyss, a cliff in the ocean, and the deeper you go, the more water pressure there is, and it'll crush that ship. Just give an example of how pressure is real. There you go. There's pressure on a styrofoam cup crushing it down. Because all the airspace in between the styrofoam will crush down. That same thing is going to happen to the submarine in a second. The water pressure will crush the sub, and this guy is about to have a real bad day. Zoom in on this part for you here. Down he goes. The deeper he goes, the more the pressure increases, right? This is water pressure, but it's the same concept as air pressure. And it's increasing, increasing. His ears are popping like crazy. I'm sure you've swam down to the bottom of a pool and felt your ears pop. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. Boop. And that's what you call an implosion, folks. Implosion. All right, let me recenter here. Okay. That's about right, right there. Okay. So take a look at this chart. It totally goes through the pressure in the different layers of the atmosphere. You can see where we are, the troposphere. We have the greatest amount of pressure, of course. And the higher you go, pressure decreases very quickly. By the time you get up to the stratopause, there's almost no pressure left because there's almost no air left, right? You need air to exert that pressure on you, okay? This graph here, take a second, see if you can pencil that in, altitude versus pressure, right? Hit pause, see if you can figure that out for a second. You can see at sea level, there's a lot more weight on our heads, and as you climb a mountain, there's less weight because literally there's less air on top of you once again, all right? This graph, boom, there it is. The higher you go, the less pressure there is. Classic inverse relationship. And there's your definition for altitude. Make sure you get that in there. Okay. How does this relate with moisture? Well, if you take a look, colder air, the molecules are closer together. So it's denser and would exert more pressure. Generally, on cooler days, it's higher pressure and drier conditions. We'll talk about that later. But cooler is denser, so more pressure. The opposite, of course, on a very, very hot day, the air molecules are more spread out, less dense, therefore less pressure. Okay? Why are the rooms different sizes? Well, of course, that's because of different temperatures, right? It's trying to relate to that whole expanding when you're hot and contracting when you're cool. Which room would weigh more? Well, the denser one, of course, right? Denser things, more matter packed into a tighter area. Of course, they have more mass. And which temperature air would have more air pressure? Well, hopefully you pick the cold room because denser air exerts more force downwards. Okay? All right. How does temperature and moisture affect pressure? Again, hit pause real quick. Try to figure if you can do these graphs on your own. First one, right, if temperature increases, you'll have less pressure, right? That's what's going on here, hotter air, less pressure. And for this one, the more moisture you have, the less pressure there is because water vapor takes up space, makes that air spread out, all right? As temperature increases, pressure will decrease, and as moisture increases, pressure will decrease as well. Both will decrease pressure, okay? Low pressure, right, warm temperature and humid air. We like to say low is wet and warm. That's referring to low pressure. And we like to say that high is dry and cool. High pressure is cooler temperatures and drier air. Okay? All right. So how do we measure air pressure? Well, the instrument is called a barometer, and there's a couple types. This one is called a classic aneroid barometer. But the old school way, kind of looked like this. It was a glass tube, kind of like a test tube, and they sucked the air out. It was a vacuum, and it was put into a dish of mercury. Now, the air pressure on the outside would push down on the mercury, forcing the mercury to rise up, and that would tell you how much air pressure is on that day. Of course, the opposite of that, if the air were rising outside, that would make this column of mercury go down, and you would get a different air pressure reading. This instrument, however, to be accurate, has to be about 3 feet tall, and it's all glass, plus mercury is a toxic liquid. So we've kind of steered away from it. It was very accurate, but because of that, we've steered away from it and gone to this one, the aneroid barometer, which works off of a series of springs and metal mechanisms, no mercury in there. But anyways, falling barometer means low pressure. Falling barometer means the pressure is dropping, and that means a storm coming, right? Like last week, we had all that crazy rain. That was very low pressure, right? It was the tail end of a hurricane. Rising barometer, higher pressure, right? The weekend, the weather improved, if you recall. That pressure went up, the storm went away, the sun came out. It was beautiful. Okay? Converting between inches of mercury and millibars is just like converting temperatures that we did last week. You just got to go opposite sides of the line. On the left side is millibars, on the right side is inches. Okay? So take a minute, try to fill out this chart using that scale. Okay? Hopefully for your first one, you came up with 1021. For your second check, I hope you came up with 28.88. Right? If you look, 978, find it over here. It's all the way down here if you go over, right? 2888. For that first one there, 1021 millibars, well, that would be here. Scoot over and you get 30.15. And then you keep going. Check your answers on that. Okay? All right, obviously I'll take questions in the GC, not the GC, in the meet, when we're finished here. All right, you have some summary questions as well, right? Go through them all very carefully, and we'll chat about this in the meet. See you in a bit.